Prošlo je dosta vremena od kada smo oprali noge jedni drugima i uzeli hleb i vino.
It's been a long time since we were able to participate in the ordinance to partake in wine and bread.
Kao što je rekao naš Gospod Isus Hristos,
as our Lord Jesus Christ has said,
treba da peremo jedni drugima noge.
We need to wash each other's feet.
Jer kad je on kao Gospod i učitelj oprao nama noge i mi smo dužni jedni drugima prati noge.
If he is a Lord and God washed our feet, we are to wash each other's.
Danas želimo da pokažemo da hoćemo da budemo kao i on.
Today we want to show that we would like to be like he is.
On se ponizio i oprao je noge svojim učenicima.
He has belittled himself and washed the feet of his disciples.
I zato i mi danas želimo da pokažemo tu vrstu poniznosti.
And we would like to show likewise here this morning.
Uzećemo danas hleb i vino.
Today we will take bread and wine.
A hleb i vino predstavljaju Hristovo telo i njegovu krv.
And bread represents his body and the wine represents his blood.
Mi se sećamo onoga šta je Isus uradio za nas u prošlosti.
We remember what Jesus had done for us in the past.
Ali u isto vreme po njegovim rečima razmišljamo o onome što će se dogoditi.
And through his word we think about what is to happen.
Kao što je on rekao, dokle ne dođe.
And as he said, until he comes.
I kada on bude došao u njegovom carstvu, on je obećao da će se ponovo jesti rod vinogradarski.
And he has promised when we get into his kingdom that we will be eating the fruit of the land again.
Dozvolite mi u nekoliko narednih minuta da kažem par reči o onome šta ćemo mi uraditi, šta to zapravo predstavlja.
And allow me in a few minutes and few words to express what we are about to do.
Posebno bih želeo da govorim o krvi.
I would in particular like to talk to you this morning about blood.
Zato što vino koje ćemo uzeti zapravo predstavlja Hristovu krv.
Because the wine that we are going to take in represents Christ's blood.
Vi znate da je u Bibliji krv predstavljena kao nešto posebno.
And you do know yourselves that in the Bible the blood is represented as something else.
I imate ovaj tekst u trećoj knjizi Mojsijevoj 17:14.
And the text in Leviticus 17:14 says.
On kaže da je duša svakog tela krv njegova, to mu je duša.
For the life of all flesh is its blood.
Da, u srpskom prevodu kaže duša je zapravo u krvi. Što je u principu to život.
Okay, instead of in Serbian it says the soul. Instead of flesh.
Znači, nama je jasno, govori se ovdje o životu.
Of course, it's very clear that it's been spoken about life.
I zanimljivo je da Bog kaže ko bi god jeo krv da se istrebi.
And it's interesting that God said whoever eats blood he should be eliminated.
I mi ovdje razumemo kolika je važnost zapravo te krvi.
And here we understand just how important is the blood.
I ako čitamo Bibliju od samog početka,
and if we do read the Bible from the very beginning,
mi ćemo razumeti da je to prolivanje krvi uvek imalo određeni značaj.
And we will understand that shedding of the blood had a special meaning.
Posebno ovdje sada mislim na žrtve.
And of course here I look at sacrifices.
Najvažnija žrtva je bilo jagnje.
And the most important sacrifice was the lamb.
Šta se dogodilo sa jagnjetom?
So what did happen with the lamb?
Njegova krv je bila prolivena.
And its blood was shed.
I ljudi onog vremena su jasno znali da ta služba ima posebno značaj.
And people of that time knew that that particular ordinance had special meaning.
Kasnije u službi u svetinji sve se takođe vrtelo oko prolivanja krvi.
And later on everything that was happening in the temple was around the sacrifice and the blood.
Dakle, možemo slobodno reći da je prolivanje krvi bila centralna služba.
And we can freely say that shedding of the blood was the central service.
I mi se možemo pitati zašto je to tako, zašto prolivanje krvi?
And we would maybe ask ourselves why did that happen?
Zar je bilo potrebno, toliko žrtava, toliko krvi da se prolije?
Was it so important that so many sacrifices should be shed.
Bog je dao Mojsiju zapovest da u vreme izlaska iz Egipta namažu dovratnike vrata sa krvlju.
And as Israelites were to depart Egypt, they were given a command to paint the doorposts with the blood.
I ponovo imamo situaciju da je krv predstavljala nešto posebno.
And there we see that blood represented something special.
U ovom slučaju to je bila zaštita.
And in this instance it was protection.
Prosveštenik u svetinji jednom godišnje je takođe prinosio krv.
And the priest once a year would bring the blood into the most holy.
Krv je bila sredstvo očišćenja, a ne voda, što je zanimljivo.
And it was the blood that was cleansing, not the water.
I takođe, kad je u pitanju zavet, kad je u pitanju stari zavet,
and when we get to the Old Testament,
stari zavet je bio potvrđen krvlju.
And the Old Testament was
sealed
by the blood.
Znači, kaže ovde u izlasku 24:6-8, druga Mojsijeva 24:6-8.
And in Exodus 24:6-8 says,
da je Mojsije krvlju pokropio oltar, ali i narod.
We are told that Moses, he sprinkled blood on the basins, but also on the people.
Ajde sada da kažemo nekoliko reči o krvi Isusa Hrista.
Let's speak about the blood of Jesus Christ.
Koja je važnost Hristove krvi?
So what importance is the blood of Christ?
Rekli smo koji je bio značaj životinske krvi.
Well, we mentioned what was the meaning of the animal's blood.
Ali Novi Zavet jasno govori da životinska krv nije mogla ništa da postigne.
And the New Testament clearly states that the blood of the animals could not achieve anything.
Životinska krv je bila samo simbol.
And animal's blood was just a symbol.
Kada Isus imao sa učenicima ono što zovemo poslednja večera.
And when Jesus had with his disciples the last supper,
on je rekao da to vino predstavlja njegovu krv.
And he said that the wine represented his blood.
Ali u isto vreme on kaže ta čaša ona je novi zavet u moji krvi.
And he said that the cup is the new covenant in his blood.
Kao što je u starom zavetu krv bila sredstvo zaveta.
And just like in the Old Testament that the blood was the covenant.
Tako i u Novom zavetu krv je sredstvo zaveta.
And just likewise in the New Testament blood is also the covenant.
Ovoga puta to je Hristova krv.
And in this instance it's the blood of Jesus Christ.
Evo nekoliko biblijskih tekstova koji nam govore o tome šta smo mi dobili u Hristovoj krvi.
And we will go through a few verses and to realize and see what we have achieved or what we have received through Jesus's blood.
Kaže apostol Pavle da imamo izbavljenje u krvi njegovoj i oproštenje greha.
And apostle Paul says that we have redemption through his blood and forgiveness.
Zatim u Jevrejima 9:12 apostol Pavle kaže ona krv od različitih životinja nije mogla da nas otkupi.
And apostle Paul says further that the blood from all those different types of animals could not redeem us.
I kaže Pavle, večni otkup smo dobili kroz krv Isusa Hrista.
And we have received everlasting redemption through the blood of Jesus Christ.
U 1. Petrovo 1:18-19.
And in 1. Peter 1:18-19.
Kaže apostol Petar da ne postoji nikakvo sredstvo kojim bi mi mogli platiti svoje iskupljenje.
Apostle Paul tells us there is no means that we could actually redeem ourselves.
Jedini način kako se možemo iskupiti jeste krvlju Isusa Hrista.
And the only way we can be redeemed is through the blood of Jesus Christ.
U 1. Jovanovo 1:7.
In 1. John 1:7.
Kaže Jovan da krv Isusa Hrista, sina njegova, očišćava nas od svakog greha.
We are told that the blood of Jesus Christ cleanses us from all sins.
Drugim rečima, ne postoji greh koji ne može biti očišćen. Vrlo zanimljivo.
In other words, there is no sin that cannot be cleansed.
U svakom slučaju, postoje neki uslovi pre nego što se taj greh očisti.
And of course, there are some things that need to be done prior to that.
Apostol Pavle kaže u Jevrejima 9:22 da bez prolivanja krvi nema oproštenja.
And in Hebrews 9:22 apostle Paul says without blood there is no remission.
Dakle jedini način da nama bude oprošteno jeste da se krv prolije.
And the only way that we can be forgiven is when the blood is shed. I kao što smo rekli,
ta krv je već prolivena.
And that blood is already shed.
U Otkrivenju 1:5 apostol Jovan piše.
In Revelation 1:5 apostle John says
da nas je on oprao od greha svojom krvlju.
That he washed us from our own sins in his own blood.
I kao što vidite, zanimljivo, nije voda sredstvo pranja i očišćenja.
As you can see, and it's interesting that the water is not the means of washing ourselves.
Nego je to krv.
But it is the blood.
Zamislite sada kada bi uzeli vi krv i sipali na sebe i neko vas pita šta radiš, a ti kažeš ja se perem.
Can you imagine taking the blood and trying to and pouring it upon yourself and someone would ask you what are you doing and you say well I'm cleansing myself.
Verovatno da to ne bi imalo smisla za ljude.
Of course that wouldn't have any meaning to anyone.
Ali Biblija jasno govori krv Isusa Hrista ona nas zapravo pere od naših greha.
But the Bible is very clear that the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ is what washes us.
Također apostol Pavle u Rimljanima 5:9 kaže da smo njegovom krvlju opravdani.
And in Romans 5:9 apostle Paul says that we are justified by his blood.
Sama reč opravdanje je suprotna osudi.
And the word justify is opposite to condemned.
Dakle, neko hoće da vas osudi.
Somebody wants to condemn you.
A vi dobijete opravdanje.
But you get justification.
To je ono o čemu apostol Pavle ovdje govori.
And this is what apostle Paul is speaking
Kako
about.
Kako se to dogodilo?
Now, how did that happen?
Hristovom krvlju.
It happened through Christ's blood.
I evo ovdje, a u Jevrejima 13:12 apostol Pavle također piše da nas je Hristo svojom krvlju osvetio ili posvetio.
And in Hebrews 13:12 apostle Paul says that we are sanctified by his blood.
I zaista ako čitamo ove tekstove pažljivo.
And if we read these verses carefully.
Vidjet ćemo koliki je značaj Hristove krvi.
We will notice how important is blood of Christ.
Sve ono što je čovjeku potrebno za potpuno spasenje.
Everything that is required for one's salvation.
Sve kažu pisci Novog Zaveta se dogodilo u Hristovoj krvi.
And that everything had happened in the blood of Jesus.
I također apostol Pavle kaže da Hristovom krvlju mi smo dobili jedan poseban vid slobode.
And through Jesus's blood we have received freedom.
A to je da ulazimo u najsvetije mjesto.
And that is that we can enter the most holy.
Da priđemo Bogu, njegovoj prisutnosti.
That we can enter into his presence.
Dakle, vi znate da je čovjek na početku izgubio tu mogućnost da sa Bogom bude blizak licem k licu.
You know that in the beginning a human has lost that privilege of speaking to God face to face.
Apostol Pavle kaže da se to sad vratilo u prvobitno stanje.
And apostle Paul tells us that that has returned in that in as it used as it once was.
Krvlju Isusa Hrista mi ponovo možemo biti sa Bogom licem k licu.
Through the blood of Jesus we can come into the presence of God face to face.
I evo ovog jutra dok budemo uzimali to vino.
And this morning while we are partaking into the wine.
Imajmo na umu šta je Gospod Isus Hristos uradio za nas.
Let's keep it in mind what Jesus Christ had done for us.
To vino je simbol njegove krvi.
The wine is the symbol of his blood.
A u njegovoj krvi imamo potpuno spasenje.
But in his blood we have total salvation.
Neka nas Bog sve blagoslovi dok budemo učestvovali u ovim obredima.
May God bless us while we partake in this ordinance.
Ja ću vas zamoliti sada da svi ustanemo.
I would ask you all to stand.
I pomolit ćemo se Bogu pre nego što krenemo na obred poniznosti.
And we will stand and pray before we go to foot washing.
Oče naš sveti pravedni.
Our heavenly and righteous Father.
U ovim posebnim svečanim trenucima.
And in this holy moment.
Mi te molimo za tvoju milost.
We are praying for your mercy.
Pomozi da učestvujemo u ovim obredima i da ti budemo zahvalni.
Help us to participate in this ordinance and to be thankful.
Jer tvoja sveta krv nam je dala potpuno spasenje.
And your holy blood has given us total salvation.
Pomozi da imamo to na umu dok pristupamo ovim obredima.
And help us to keep that in mind as we partake in this ordinance.
Ovo te molimo u Hristovo ime.
And we pray all this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.